Thurnos Brightsoul is clad in the white and gold of the Maelstrom of Light Stormhost. A powerful wizard, he has vanquished many a demonic foe upon countless battlefields. In this video, we're going to show how to paint Thurnos Brightsoul. We're going to paint him in the classic method and up to battle ready. Now, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've undercoated with Corax White, which is perfect for two reasons. Firstly, his armour is already base coated, and any colours we apply will be nice and bright and vibrant. So first of all, I'm going to start by painting his robes, and this is going to be with Mephiston Red. So I'm going to be using a medium layer brush for this. Now I'm just going to apply a little bit to my palette like so, not too much. A little touch of water so it's not too thick and goopy. Then we're ready to start painting. It's always key to try and get your brush to a nice point, so just spin it around like so on the paint. Then we're ready to start painting. So I'm going to start with the sleeve first. Now you probably want to apply a couple of thin coats just to build up that layer. And don't forget to paint his tassel and also the back of his cloak as well. There we are with the red cloth now done. We're going to move on to applying some more base coats. Now we're going to start with dried bark for any leather details and also the soil on his base. After that, we're going to move to Xandra Dust for his tabard, Retributor Armor for any gold details, Cantor Blue for the blue shoulder pauldrons, and finally after that, we're going to use Rakar Flesh for both the hair and the skin. But first of all, let's start with that dried bark. So I'm going to continue using my medium layer brush, just apply a little bit to the palette, a little touch of water as well, and we're ready to start painting. So like I say, there's only a couple of details to worry about here. So you've got his gauntlets, so the leather on his gloves, his belt, and also the soil on the base. There we are with the dry bark now applied. We're going to move on to using Xandra Dust for the tabard. Now during the early stages of applying the base coat, sometimes it's a lot easier to tidy up as you go along. But with the actual white armour, I'm going to do that at the very end because there's plenty more base coats to apply. So I'm more likely to splodge on that as well. With the tabard now done, we're going to move on to applying Retributor Armour for all the gold details. Now, if you're not entirely sure where all the gold details are, just check your box art for details. There we are with the gold details now done. We're going to move on to painting the shoulder pauldrons, and for this we're using Cantor Blue. With the shoulder pauldrons now painted, we're going to move on to painting the skin and the hair. For this we'll be using Rakar Flesh. Now at this point they're both going to look the same, but once we start applying those shades, because we'll be using two different shades, then they'll really stand out from each other. There we are, with those main colours now picked out, we're going to move on to applying some more details to Thurnos. We're going to start with the metal details, or silver details. For this we'll be using Iron Hand Steel. We're then going to move on to the weapon hasp. For this we'll use Screamer Pink, and the flame in his hand we're going to pick out using Thousand Suns Blue. But first of all, let's start those silver details. I'm just going to apply some Iron Hand Steel. It's in the corner just at the top there. A little bit of water, and we're ready to start base coating those silver details. Now there's not many, it's mainly his sword and some details on his staff. So if we just spin the model around, you can see he's got his sword here, so we'll just start picking that out. And if you make any mistakes, just tidy back up with those base coats. And there's the anvil to do on his staff. With the silver details now done, we're going to use Screamer Pink to pick out those weapon halves. Again, you might just want to do a couple of thin coats when applying this. And there we are with the Screamer Pink now done. We're going to move on to applying Thousand Suns Blue to the flame. Again, you want to do a couple of thin coats on this. And after that, we're then ready to move on to painting the base. And there we are with the flame in his hand now done. We're going to move on to the final few base coats by picking out the actual base that he stood on. Now we're going to start with Mechanica Standard Grey for all the stonework, Deathwood Forest for any leaves, and Phoenician Purple for any vials. Now some of these vials will be on the base, but also on the model as well. So first of all, let's start with the Mechanica Standard Grey. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette, a little bit of water. Once we're ready, we can start applying that onto the model. So you've got a few bits of stonework to pick out, so just be careful around it actually with his feet. And then once you've done that, you can just start heavily applying it to all those stones. If you do find you get on some of that dirt, just tidy it back up with dried bark. There we are with the stonework now done. We're just going to pick out the leaves using Deathwild Forest. The leaves on the base now done, all that's left to do is to paint the vials on the base as well as the ones on the model. Now you want to do a couple of thin coats of these just to make them pop out. The other thing to do is, once that's all done, is then to start painting the armour white or touch up any splodges you've made. And there we are with all those base coats now applied. We're going to move on to applying some shades. Now we're going to start with Agraxer shade first. This is going to be on the armour and the red as well as all over the base. After that, we're going to move on to Reichland Flesh Shade for the gold and the skin, Seraphim Sepia for the hair and the tabard, and anything else we're going to coat with Norn Oil. But first of all, let's start with that Agrax Earth Shade. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette like so. Now, I'm only going to apply a little bit here and get my brush to a nice point, because for the armor, I'm going to do something called a recess shade, where we're just going to be very careful and just apply it into all those recesses. If you get some by accident on the large areas of the white, just tidy back up with Corax White. And for the base and the red, or the robes, just apply it all over. There we are with the Agraf's Earth shade now applied. We're going to move on to using Reichlin Flesh shade. Now we're going to start on the face, so just be really neat here. And if you do make any mistakes and get on the hair, just tidy back up. This will really make that skin pop out and look really vibrant and ruddy. And also don't forget to apply it to the gold as well. Again, this will help it stand out and give it a nice blingy effect. There we are with the Reichlin Flesh shade now applied. We're going to start applying Seraphim Sepia. So this will be to the hair and also to the tabard. There we are with the Seraphim Sepia now applied. All that's left to do is apply Norn Oil to all the areas that have not been touched by a shade yet. So that's things like the half, the gloves, the blue. I'm also going to apply it to the hair again, just in some of those deeper recesses, just to add some more definition. There we are with the shades now dry and the rim of the base painted a bad and black. Thurnos Brightsoul is now battle ready. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when using base paints, try and be as neat as you can. Remember, the neater you are, the better the end result. And should you make any mistakes, you can always neat them back up with those base paints. Secondly, when using shades, try not to overload your brush too much, as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find this happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own battle-ready Maelstrom of Light Stormcast, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.